than what we call a lip sync assassin.
When it's time to turn it on, she turns it on. This is bigger than just HIV. You know, we touch other people in other ways because people suffer from depression and anxiety, and all of these things have, you know, stigma behind it.
I was that 1.34%, and I never thought I would have been. When I dance on stage about my HIV, my kind of worries or doubts about myself is just gone.
This is the way to end the epidemic. I mean, this works. It really works.
The purpose of the Slay Stigma Tour is to convey the message that you equals you, so that undetectable equals untransmittable.
It's a new world of HIV. It's the last era of HIV. This is a great way of getting people in the door and then educating them in a way that they'll remember.
What this positivity movement is doing is exactly that. It's spreading that positive movement from coast to coast to coast.
The small things matter. Yellowknife might be small, but it's very mighty in terms of support for the LGBTQ2S community.
In Winnipeg and on the prairies in general, Indigenous queens have been holding it down long before RuPaul's Drag Race.
I'm the Goblin Queen of the Lekwungen territories. You know, I basically somatically work out my shit. I'm a drag monster.
There's also like something really cool about Moncton, where like we're like a big village.
Support your local queen.
Anybody that dresses differently or is gender non-conforming or non-binary, like, we'll know that's there.
We weren't just slaying stigma, we were just slaying every way possible.
U equals U and undetectable equals untransmittable. That message needs to be shared with folks living with HIV, both those diagnosed and those undiagnosed.
We're gonna fucking slay stigma.
It's literally wrapped around this country. And I think that there's a lot more to be had.
This is some intense stuff.
Ooh, rev, rum, rum, grrr.
Hey, Dad.
Oh, that guy called me a fag the other day.
Oh, yep. Oh my God, I want to suck it.